Hey, what's up, guys? So today I want to go ahead and show you guys a quick little review of the Milwaukee Packout, and this is going to be an HVAC edition Packout. All right, and so I work as an HVAC installer, so I do a lot of rough-ins and, you know, new construction rough-ins, and also I do a lot of trims. Okay, now a trim is whenever you go and put the air handler, condenser, and then put up all your grills in the house, okay? And that's after the house is basically, you know, done, has drywall all in it and everything. So yeah, anyways, so before I get to the review on the Packout, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel, guys, and give me a thumbs up. And if you already have subscribed, then go ahead and please give me a thumbs up, guys. And now let's get to this Packout. All right,
guys, so with my Packout, I have the bottom one with the wheels, I have the middle chest, I have this smaller screw organizer, and then I have the milk crate, okay? Now, I'm gonna go ahead and go through all of them, just so you guys can have an idea of everything that I have. And also, you know, for you guys that are probably interested in working in HVAC as an installer, then you can kind of get an idea of the stuff that you need to carry and maybe the tools that you should be looking into. So let's go ahead and get started with the first milk crate right there. All right, guys, so I go ahead and carry a couple of float switches. All right, and I just throw them in there. So whenever I have to do an install with an air handler, and then I go ahead and carry some duct tape and some shirt tape in here. I have my black nylon strap. This is for the flexible duct, so you can strap it up. I carry gloves, guys, okay? Make sure you have gloves, very important, because those air handlers, they're sharp. I got a lot of PVC fittings, okay? See that? I carry pencils, all right? I got a black marker, and this is the thick ones. PVC cutters. I have some of those isolation pads or ISO pads. You know, they're rubber pads to go underneath your condensers for the noise or vibration. I have PVC glue, Armaflex glue, some foam, spray glue. I got little black zip ties, okay? This is for your copper, so you know you can zip tie your Armaflex and your thermostat wire and also your liquid line to your, you know, your big copper. And then got some staples for my staple gun. I have paintbrushes. This right here is some soapy water. So I use this for drains, for whenever I need to put the Armaflex on it, or, you know, I need to snake some Armaflex through the drain lines, because it's kind of, sometimes they get stuck, and if you don't have any soapy water to be able to, you know, for so it can allow it to slide a lot easier, then it's very difficult and it ends up tearing a lot. But go ahead and use soapy water, guys. That's a really quick and easy way to make sure you get your Armaflex all the way through your drain lines without any problems. I also have some markers right here. All right. What else? Oh, I have some stud guards right here. This is so that, you know, for your dryer pipes, your drain lines, you don't want any screws going through those, so you have to make sure you put stud guards on them. I also have some metal hanging strap right here. And this is for, you know, to strap whatever for your dryer pipes. Also, you can use this metal strap for your drain lines whenever you have an air handler that hangs, to make sure that your drain lines don't, you know, start falling. You know, you want to make sure they're supported, okay? All right, guys, so that is the milk crate right here. And now we're gonna go ahead and get to our second one, which is going to be the ones that have all my screws in it. All right.
And also, real quick, guys,
The way you take these packouts out is right here. This is the release,
which I thought this was the most coolest thing ever. All right. Because a lot of other systems, they have it where it's on the sides, and you know, sometimes it's not that easy to be able to unlatch it, especially when it's right next to a, like a drawer or something, or something, you know, a structure like the wall. Then you're kind of trying to get it, but it's sometimes too difficult. So it's really cool that they incorporated this right here in the front. It's so easy to get access to that. All right. Okay, guys, so now we're getting to my screws. All right, so. And notice how this, it just stays open like that. That's awesome. So you're not fighting with it or nothing. It, you flip it open and it stays open. All right. Okay, guys, so. If you look in here, I carry self-tappers. Those are the flush ones. I use these with my stud guards right here, okay? These right here, I have my 5/16 self-tappers. And this I use usually with my air handlers. And also, if I need to use them for the condenser, for the hurricane straps, and as well as my hangers for my... my metal hanging, if I need to use it for the drain lines. All right, and right here, I have a bunch of washers. See that? All right. And then I have my extension nuts, my nut extension right here. This is for the all thread. Whenever they're too short, you have to extend them. I have drywall right here, drywall screws. They are 1¼ inches. I have peanut screws. I have my grommets right here. I have my tapcons and a tapcon bit right there. Right here, I have my 3-inch screws, drywall screws. And I have my ramset pins right here. And then I have the ramset bullets right there. That's used with the ramset for the line covers. Right here, I have my 3/8 nuts, hex nuts. And this is just another thing of hex nuts, 3/8. All right, guys, so that is my screws. Go ahead and latch that back up. And now I'll go ahead and take this off. All right, guys, so now we're getting to my third box. This is the medium tool chest. Also, a very quick note is that this handle needs to be all the way down for this lid to be able to stay open. All right, so let me go ahead and show you that. That so this won't open and you can't do anything, so you can grab something real quick if you need to, but if you want this to stay open, guys, you have to put the handle down, okay? And then that's perfect right there, okay? All right, guys, now we're getting to the fun stuff. So right here, in this top case, I carry a laser measuring tape. Bosch, really nice. And then I have some squeegees in there. I got me a speed square, a level, another squeegee, 2 9/16 wrenches, another squeegee,
sawzall blade. I got me a flathead screwdriver, extra Phillips bits. This has like a little thing right there. This is a locking cap from the condenser. And I have these bad boys. These are Craftsman. So I use these a lot with those for when I do my installs. Got my linemans. So I got these right here. The vice grips. I got 1.5-inch bit to go through wood. This is for my drains, and this is for my thermostat right here. This is 1/2-inch. This is a 9/16 hollow bit, so I can use that for my, let's see, look, it's hollow. So it's like a 5 inches, I think. So I use that for my all thread. Usually whenever I'm doing the hangers for the air handlers. And here I just have a lot more bits for going through wood. I have a little copper cutter right here. I have a spare battery, and it's Milwaukee, of course. Here I have a little pry bar. Just a little pry bar and like a little vice, Milwaukee vice grip thing there. All right, so let's get to the next part. All right, guys, so in here, I have my DeWalt stapler. All right, awesome stapler, guys. I really recommend this one. I have my Milwaukee snips. All right, I just recently did a review on these, and I've been using them for already about maybe 2 or 3 weeks. So they've been working good. I have my crimpers, Malco. I use this little Husky, I forget what it's called, but it's a little pouch. Oh, I think it is a pouch, yeah. The Husky pouch. I put drywall screws in there, so I connect, I have a zip tie on my ladder, and I just connect this to my zip tie, and then I'm able to just reach in here and grab screws as I'm working. And I have drywall, or not drywall. Yeah, these are the drywall screws, and then this is the peanut screws inside. So I just put my bit in while I'm on my ladder, and I pull out bits, or I pull out the peanut screws. All right, so yeah, so this is a really good pouch to have. Really cool. All right, guys, I have an extra battery for Porter cable. To my sawzall right here. Really nice sawzall. I have my Milwaukee impact and hammer drill. All right, this is the fuel generation 1. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, because this has the 1 and the 2 speeds right there. All right. So, I really like this one a lot because it has the 2 speeds. So, I usually use that first speed when I'm working with my air handler. This way I don't overstrip something because, you know, those screws can be a little delicate. So, you know. Yeah, and then, you know, the hammer drill. I got my ram set right here. This is to install my line covers for the copper. I have my Milwaukee flashlight right here. High review on this too, guys. If y'all want to check that out. More gloves, guys. You got to be safe out there. You can get cut really easily. I have my favorite pair of tin snips right here. Offsets, 45 degrees. This is the Midwest. All right, I'll probably do a review on these later. Copper cutters. I have the Craftsman hammer right here, and make sure you always get yourself a metal one, guys, because I had a fiberglass one. It was nice that it was lightweight, but it broke really easy. This metal one has lasted me already over a year, so it works good. And I have me right here a little chipping tool. This way I can just break through a block on the inside and the outside, and then I can run my dryer vent through there. All right, let me put everything back. Oh, real quick. I also have some Milwaukee bits right here. See that, guys? This is a Malco bit right here. It is awesome. Look for it, guys. Quarter inch and 5/16. Reversible. I also have the DeWalt drill bits. Okay. Really good, guys. I like how they made the DeWalt one really small because it's so compact. Alright, let's put everything all the way back in here. My gloves. All right, guys, we're down to my last one. So let's go ahead and see what I have in there. That last one also props up, so that's cool. All right, guys, so in this one, I have my hot block. All right, so this is so, you know, if I'm soldering or anything, brazing, whatever, it helps to not overheat anything that I don't want overheated. I got my reverse bending attachments right here. This goes to my Uniweld bender. I have a review for that if y'all want to check it out. I have this mask in here. I don't remember why I put it in there. I have a mirror. It's a little broken, but it still works, right? Got me some more blades. Squeegee, locking caps for the condenser. I have me a long bit right here for my all thread, 9/16. This is the Makita 9/16 right there. Really good to have one of those, guys, so check them out. That back there. Oh, drywall knife right here, guys. You need one of those too. Awesome. Down here, this is where I keep my bender. All right, Black Max bender. This is my swedge tool right here. This is the manual swedger. And then we have my favorite one right here, the NAVAC hydraulics wedge tool or tube expander. Really nice. Okay, so I had a review on these three tools that I just showed you right now. So if you want, go ahead and check them out. They're on my channel. And yes, guys, all these tools do take a pretty big beating. So I recommend every single tool that you've seen here. They have been tried, and trust me, if you get them, you will not be disappointed. All right, if you see the Milwaukee toolbox, it is dirty. It sits in my truck, and also I take it out whenever I get to every job site just so I can have all my tools right there in one spot. And sometimes I end up having to park my vehicle probably about a block away, depending on how much people are working in the same house. So the benefit of having this Milwaukee Packout is that you can literally pack it with everything you need for that job just about, and then you don't have to worry about having to run out to your truck every single time, you know? So really, this crate right here, awesome benefit, because I just load that thing with everything that I need for that specific job, and then I'm good to go. And these boxes here, man, they carry everything that I need. All my screws, all the tools I need for that job. And if I need a special tool, then I also have more tools, obviously. But for specifically installing, you know, rough-in installs and then also trim installs, I have just about everything I need right here, okay? Now, I may have other stuff, but usually this is all I need right here. And I just love the fact that this one has this handle right here, so you can either carry it like this, because this thing is heavy, so I have to actually carry it like this. And then you have to hold the back handle, and you press it in. Flip that down, it's good to go. And you need to take it off. I pull it off with this or with this. And then you can carry it with one hand. I have a messed up arm, but it is heavy, so you are not gonna be walking your stuff. You know what I mean? So it'll be uncomfortable like that. So you have to pick it up like this, and then it's comfortable. But why do that when you have wheels, right? Also, I really like that it has these, I think they're aluminum or metal, I'm not sure, but might be aluminum. But I like that it has these so you can grab onto it, because sometimes this thing is backed up all the way against the wall, so you kind of have to tilt it and roll it so you can get behind it. This is the screw organizers. Just falls into place, guys. You don't have to really like put it on there and then you're trying to get it to latch. You kind of just place it on there and it kind of finds its way in there, so you're not struggling too much. And then when you have a lot of stuff, then you want to hold the back and press it in, because if not, it's gonna roll back on you. All right. And works really nice. One-handed operation right here. Or you can do two hands. Whatever is more comfortable. Go ahead and check out the back right there. See that? So you see all these scuff marks right here? This is from me getting up onto a concrete slab. So, I mean, it's like a daily thing, though. So, it gets scuffed up daily. But it works really good, guys. Yeah, so Milwaukee really hit out the park with this system. It's really awesome. I mean, it's not heavy or anything, guys. I mean, that right there, that's carrying a lot of weight right now. So, Milwaukee really hit it out the park. I love this Milwaukee system. Honestly, I wish I would have bought it sooner, you know? Because I always thought, I'm not going to buy that. That's too much. But realizing that all those, you know, those bottom ones, after realizing that these are all pretty much like waterproof, or not waterproof, but like they're pretty sealed, so water doesn't get in them too easily. I have yet to run water over them. I'm a little scared, you know. I have so much tools invested in there, and I don't feel like taking all that out just to water it. But anyways, I mean, they're really cool. I mean, I'm pretty sure it can withstand a good rainfall because it has a seal around them. And so I have had this system for about 4 months now, and it's worked awesome, guys. So I highly recommend this Milwaukee Packout. I would be doing a 1 year review on this to see if it ends up lasting me a year, and we'll see what happens, right? But yeah, look at them tires, man. Got some good grip on there still. And I love the fact that they're oversized tires because they allow you to get over a lot of stuff that a lot of other things just can't, you know, handle. Like, I know the Husky toolbox one, the rolling toolbox, I've tried that one, man. It's a little bit of a pain sometimes. But this one is just awesome. I mean, look at these metal latches right here. I mean, this part's plastic, but this is just awesome, man. So once I get to this point, I end up putting the handle down, and on the Milwaukee crate, I grab it by the sides and I tip it over. All right, once it gets to this, you pretty much just have to push it back. But you can hold it right there. It's nice and good right there. Then I have straps right here tied down. All right, and that's just to make sure it goes nowhere. You really want to be careful with this stuff. You pay a lot of money, you want to make sure it's all nice and secure. And also, sometimes I'll be in a job where I actually just move these two out the way and just get to my tools. And then that's it. Let me show you. I'll open that up and just keep the lid up. And there you go. Yeah, whatever you need. Hey guys, so I have a quick little update. So I actually went to go buy me another little organizer. And I'm using that for all my copper fittings, okay? So I actually just went to go buy it not that long ago right now. So yeah, I actually went to go buy it the same day I did the packout video, but I didn't add it on there because I did the video and then I went to go buy the packout, so, or this extra one. So this, I'm just gonna go ahead and add this to my video. But you see that? I have all my copper fittings that I need. These are 1 1/8 copper fittings, 90s. And here's the little extension coupling. I got 3/8 right there. Got some sanding paper. Have 7/8 90s, the longer 90s. I have more 1 1/8 90s. I have the short ones and the longer ones. See what I got. I also have 3/4 inch copper fittings in here. So it comes in handy. So I'm gonna test it out with this new one on Monday. See how it works out. But yeah, I just wanted to go ahead and show you guys a quick little update, just so y'all see the pack out with the copper fitting attachments in there. All right.
Hey, what's up, guys? So I just want to say thank you so much for watching my video of my Milwaukee Packout, and I hope that it was a little entertaining, maybe informative, so that maybe, you know, if you guys are interested in this type of trade, then you kind of have an idea of the type of tools that are going to be used in the trade. Also, you know, to see that I use the Milwaukee Packout in this industry, HVAC, then, you know, just so you know that it is a good system that has worked for me. So it is something I highly recommend if you guys are interested in that. And, you know, I was a little bit iffy at first. I thought, man, that's just, I don't need that. So I had like 4 different Husky bags that I would just have different tools in. And I would just take whatever I needed and take it back and grab the other one, take it back. But after a while, I thought that was just, it's just too much. So I thought, you know, let me go ahead and just buy the Milwaukee pack. I'll see how it works. And I got it, guys, and I do not regret it whatsoever. I bought that on special also, okay? So I paid $179 for the bottom toolbox with the wheels, the middle toolbox, and then for the milk crate, okay? So $179, and then I paid $34 for the screw organizer compartments. And in total, it came out to be about $227 with tax, all right? So it's a little pricey, but it's definitely worth it, guys. I mean, I'm literally blown away by how awesome that Milwaukee Packout system has worked for me. Yeah, and thanks so much for watching again, guys. Please go ahead and subscribe if you haven't yet and give me a thumbs up. And also stay tuned, guys. I will be having a whole lot more videos coming up soon. It's gonna be a lot more tutorials and also a lot of tool reviews. So I hope you guys like that type of stuff. And I will be doing a lot more work with ductwork as well. So stay tuned.